What's up?
And so.
She got new knobs.
She's got new knobs.
I didn't know if I was going to go with these or go with the gold ones. But we go with these for now. For now, it seems to go. Matches, right? All black and chrome. All the black and chrome goodness. All the black and chrome goodness. Opened it up, went in there, took a look at everything that was going on, how they wire these things, these harnesses up. I have no idea. It's all fucking crazy. And, because they got three leads going. I'm like, what the fuck are you doing? But Seymour Duncan on the front. Seymour Duncan SH1N. And I just took this one out of blue, which is VHM or HVM or HMV or MHV, some freaking thing. But it's what the pickup that I got from Stedman Pro. And I had to almost acceptance that this was going to be quieter than this. And that's okay. Apparently, this is a 59. According to Seymour Duncan, there is no SH1N that is not a 59. But that's a 59, which is... Who's going to complain about a 59? But I do know that this is good. I mean, It's from Hong Kong, from Hong Kong, because the last set were the same manufacturers, and they came from there. The set that I have put into the Stedman Pro wound up being the same manufacturers, just a different style, right? The style was. What kind of buckers were those? They were knockoff Zebras. They were knockoff Zebras, and in that thing, they sound just like Page's freaking guitar. But and only because I checked it out for no other reason. But and then these. Well, when I'm playing it in blue, they sounded awesome. But so far, mostly everybody that I've talked to have wound up changing the pickups in the pickups in these freaking things, in the Artcores. I don't know what it is, but the Artcores. Seem to have a bad rep for pickups. So, with that being said, I proceeded to do surgery. Proceeded to do surgery and see how it would work. And so since I did that. Was doing something before and I just hit a freaking note and it just kept on going and I was like, holy crap, listen to that. And it was all the way up here and I was like, oh, okay then. That Shall say that. Oh, by the way, the name is Slim. She has been dubbed Slim. And Slim fucking rocks. I still don't understand now. Watch. Somewhere, like, this is the bridge, obviously. And that's the neck, and this is the bridge. And now, in between, is not greater than the sum of the two. But hear that? Now watch, it happens. You got me. I have no idea. I think it's the phasing thing, and somehow they're trying to wire in the Peter Green tone or something like that, and I don't know if it's freaking working, but it seems to be. It's really, I don't know. And if you don't want it, quite sure I like that. I do know that I've been able to rewire that and take it out if I don't like it. The tone works pretty good and takes down a lot of that E string bite. Too shabby. Not too goddamn shabby, I must say myself. It looks classy, right? It looks classy with those knobs. I think it looks classy with the knobs. My friend was saying that she thought the other knobs had a nice, gave it a nice touch. I agree. I mean, the black on red looked really good. I think these made it look real good. Real good. Let's see if I can. Da-da-da. Da-da-da. Yeah, the freaking computer's freaking out. It's going, you're moving around too much. But that was it. Basically just making sure that I did a decent job with the surgery. I think it did. Let me call her done for now. And I will bid you pleasant adieu. Seymour Duncan, SHN or 1N, 1N. It's a 59. Who knew? And, some import. We shall not name names. What was I gonna say? Oh, yeah, before I freaking hang up. You know my Royce, right? I seen another guitar freaking completely identical. headstock, freaking the neck. In fact, the paint job looked like mine. And the guy wanted, I think it was like $165 for it, right? What the hell was it called? Majesty? Majesty? Or Majesty? I think it was Majesty or something like that. And it was almost the same writing as the Royce. And I'm like, I know that fucking guitar. I mean, even the inlays look the same. It looked the same. You know what I mean? And so, because that Royce guitar is out of Sears and Roebuck. And he's like, oh, it's a 60s, 70s guitar. I'm like, it's not a 60s, 70s guitar. First of all, it's an 80s guitar. Because they didn't want to get into the line of fire of a freaking, whatchamacallit, of, or late 70s. Late 70s, 80s. Because they didn't want to be in the line of fire ever since Gibson started, went batshit, freaking started suing people for their headstocks. Because the headstock is not the open book headstock. It doesn't have the lettering. It doesn't have nothing close to the lettering as that one. It's a plywood guitar. You know it's a plywood guitar. I'm ready to tell the guys. So I don't know why. I mean, if I wanted to, that would be nice if I could be able to get that for it. But it sounds so good. And I was just saying to Jesse, that's the guitar that I put the GFS Fat Pats in. For a $30 guitar, that thing, that bitch sings freaking. She sounds great. I mean, she sounds great. So, I don't know, but I wanted it all of a sudden. I was like, that's my guitar. I have the same one. I paid $30 for it. Because it was all beat to freaking hell. We get a chance, take a look at the Royce way back. Almost the beginning of the year way back. Spring. Last night. Before this spring? Maybe last fall? Maybe? Maybe? Oh, hell. I'm pretty sure. I think it was after surgery. So that was after November. Pretty sure. I don't know. I don't know. I'd have to really... Nah, you got me freaking curious. I gotta go back and check it out. All right. Promised that I wouldn't do the do, and I'm doing the do. So let me not freaking overstay my welcome. But anyway, yeah. Love it, man. It's freaking slamming. Got it good. Everyone, have a good one. I'll talk to you later as soon as I figure out something else to freaking talk about and get some sleep. Much needed sleep. All right, peoples. Later. Thank you, Heather.